motorcycle, go away. Okay. Hello. Last week, I talked about how I wanted my best friend to become famous. A best friend that recently passed away. So, since my best friend was on YouTube, I felt like he deserved... he deserved recognition. He got his own funeral by his family, but I don't think I've ever seen a funeral done for the passing of a channel. Because I don't think, like, even though there's more than just him on that channel, I don't think it's going to keep going. In fact, all of their videos are, they must be turned to private right now because I can't find any of them. So, this video is kind of just a way of saying goodbye to a YouTuber, a fellow YouTuber. A way of me saying goodbye to my friend, and for you to understand who this guy was. Because he meant the world to me. He still means the world to me. And it sounds so cheesy, and it sounds like, I don't know. It sounds like something a guy would say to his girlfriend, but it's not like, I've always been straight and all that, but this guy really did save my life. He, like I said in the last video, I had some dark thoughts when I lived over there, and it's, I know a lot of teenagers go through that, but he was the only one who stopped me. He didn't stop me directly because he didn't even know about it, but you know, whenever I was about to do it, just thinking about him stopped me from doing anything stupid, from doing anything that would ruin my life and my friends and family's lives. And so I just want to tell his story, or the story I knew when I moved over there, to you guys. So, okay. I'm not, like I said in the last video, I'm not gonna say his name, but his story for me starts when I moved there. Moving to Missouri was very difficult for me. I had just came from a very messed up neighborhood where somehow they were able to get underneath the law and use loopholes to make it where it was almost against the school rules to bring religion into the school walls. Like, it wasn't just the teachers saying anything about it. It was the students. They couldn't pray. They couldn't read their Bible. They couldn't talk about religion at school. And coming from there, I had no friends there. I've never really had any friends until just recently. Most of the time, if I ever did have friends, they weren't very good friends. They were just people I knew. Or they're just people who weren't mean to me, you know? I never really felt like people who I called friends were really what I imagined a friend to be like. But Josh was one of those people, and it didn't start out that way. When I moved there, I was very alone. Nobody would talk to me. Nobody would sit next to me. I never had anybody even come near me. But Josh, after a couple of days, noticed that, and he sat by me, and I don't know what happened. It was just like, it felt like instant friendship chemistry. You know, like that thing where you know you're going to be best friends till the end. And from there, our friendship grew stronger. We started hanging out and we would, you know, go to each other's houses. And I remember around third or fourth grade and recess. No, let's backpedal a little bit. I remember in recess, we would swing on the, you know, like, there was nothing really to do in recess because we had no idea what to do. So we just swing on the swing sets and we'd talk. And I remember growing up that I did not ever have luck with the girls. I tried. I for sure tried. And I had a couple of girlfriends, but they broke up with me the next day. But I remember talking to Josh about how to get a girlfriend because he seemed like somebody who could get a girlfriend. And the first thing I remember him telling me was a girlfriend, the way to get a girlfriend is be a daredevil. Be somebody who isn't afraid to do the stupid stuff. And so he told me, jump off the swing set. And I did. And I did it every day until we got in trouble with the recess teacher. I never got any girlfriends, but I remember his advice. I remember one of his pickup lines was so cheesy. And at the funeral, people were talking about how all of his stupid pickup lines. You know, the one I remember the most came from Zach and Cody. And I was like, so stupid. Are you from the South? Because you're the only 10 I see. This stupid, cheesy humor he had. But he always had a way of making you laugh. He always had a way of getting you to be happy no matter what. And, you know, like, if you had a bad day, he didn't even need to talk to you. He didn't need to say anything. He just knew to goof off and be funny, and it cheered you up. Because it distracted you from what was going on. I remember that he wasn't very deep. He wasn't very deep thinking guy, but he knew how to be a friend. And I remember around fourth grade, it seemed a little, we seemed to be growing very further and further apart. We stopped hanging out. We stopped acting like friends until one day at recess, he handed me a note with a chart on it that is so stupid. I don't even care about it now. I didn't care about it then. I just was confused. But the chart basically said he wanted to quit being my friend because the more I hung out with him, the less popular he was. And I knew that. I knew I wasn't very cool. I knew people didn't like me. I didn't care, but it shocked me so much. I don't know why, but I told the recess teacher, or the whatever she's called. I told her, I handed her the note, and we ended up in the principal's office. And after that, we just shook hands, and the next day, we're best friends again. Like, nothing happened. And then, then we went back to hanging out more often. I remember the first thing we tried doing, like, we had all these stupid schemes. I was like Zach from Saved by the Bell, and I was Screech, you know. That's what I remember it being like. He was Buster Baxter, and I was Arthur, and, you know, he was always the cool guy. He was the guy people liked being around. And I was the nerdy kid that liked, that was best staying inside editing videos. But around fifth grade or so, I remember we started going to, we were coming up with a scheme to start a band. Like, we loved music, and we loved doing all this stuff, and we joined the school band just because we wanted to, I don't know why he joined, but I wanted to play drums or play jazz music or something, and so I wanted to play the trumpet or play drums or something so I could do it. And I remember the first 3 months, I hated it. I did not like it at all, because it was more than I thought it was. It was exercise, and it wasn't fun. And there's one guy that just always got on my nerves, because he thought since he was the senior, he got to boss everybody around. And I was a very slow learner, so it just made me mad. So we thought we would take our skills from band and start our own. And we wanted a rock band. I went around and asked people who knew how to play drums or guitar or something to go to tryouts. And it was, and that's what we did. We tried making a band. I bought paper jam guitar stuff, and I thought, oh, we could like record the stuff on here and do the computer generated stuff, but we never did anything. And then sometime around, it was sixth grade, because we had to do that's when we had to do the, no, it was seventh grade, because that's when we had to do the science fair stuff. We got together the first day of the year. I came up to him, and I had this stupid idea of a science fair project. After seeing a video on how to make flamethrowers, I came up to him, I'm like, dude, let's make a science fair project where we figure out how to make we test to see which aerosol can will make the best flamethrower. And we didn't care, like, we didn't care at all what, how stupid and dangerous it was. We wanted to do something like that, because that's who we are. That's who we were. Like, we wanted to do this stupid, dangerous stuff all the time. I remember before I was diagnosed, we would climb almost, like, I would climb on the inside of this, like, the tallest slide at the park, and I did stupid stuff all the time. I was a monkey back then. I climbed on everything. And I remember the next year, We did several plays for VBS with me and my dad of Bible Man, because that was my favorite superhero growing up. And one year in Wichita, when we lived there, my dad put on a Bible Man play where he dressed up as Bible Man, and they had the youth pastor like have the villain costume on. And I loved it so much. I've always wanted to do it, and I still to this day, when I grow up, I want to make a Bible Man movie. I loved doing it so much because of the sword fighting and the superheroes and everything. And I remember going up to Josh, I'm like, dude, do you want to be a villain in a play? And he's like, he just kind of gave me this look like, are you serious? You know? But I convinced him to do it, and I don't know. At one point, it just kind of, we kind of ended up just having my dad and I do it. And, but I remember, we'd always get each other on stupid schemes. That's why I remember the most about him, was we're always trying to come up with something to do that was out of the ordinary and fun for us, because yeah, he loved the same things that most people liked in that town. Because we're in that town, yeah, if you were white, straight, loved hunting, loved sports, and knew, and you were a farmer, if you weren't a farmer, you fit in. But if you were all five of those things, you were definitely able to fit in. The less things that you were at that list, the harder it was to fit in. And yeah, Josh was he hunted. But he wasn't a farmer. He loved sports. So it is easy for him to fit in, but I liked going outside, but I didn't like sports. I didn't like farming at all. I hate labor. I want to be an actor when I grow up, so I hated jobs that were rural. You know, like I'd rather have an urban job, if that makes sense. But Josh liked the same things I did. He was one of the very few people who liked it. He liked music, he liked TV, he liked staying up all night binge-watching Netflix. He liked just coming up with stupid schemes, and once I started my YouTube channel, it wasn't very long until he joined afterwards. And I remember so much of it was just having fun with him. And yeah, it's after a while, I started, yeah, it was like eighth grade or something. I noticed the church we were staying at, my dad was working at, they weren't treating us very well. They were complaining about a lot of stupid stuff, like the music and the what was on the billboard outside, and they complained about everything. They complained about the carpet, and you know, they complained about how you know, I had cancer, and they were complaining that instead of staying home, puking and barely able to keep food down, I had lost 90, I was under like, what, 30 pounds? I was less than a size zero, and they were telling me I had to go to church. I was sick, and they didn't treat us very well. And I I kind of knew that we'd have to move. But, by then, he started his YouTube channel, and, you know, the day we moved, I remember inviting everybody to the going away party. I remember everybody I knew was invited. And I think, I know two people showed up to the going away party, and I think four other people just signed the shirt. Because we had this shirt that they could sign to basically say goodbye. And there was him and a guy that moved from Egypt that we're friends with him too. He came, and he's an awesome guy. He's like, he's smarter than a computer, but I remember sitting there, and I feel so bad for doing this, but my mom had set out a water balloon fight so I could do one last thing with my friends, and I would not let them touch any of it, because I wanted to wait till everybody got there, and nobody showed up, except for those two guys. And he was one of them. And I knew, because they showed up, they were true friends. They were people who cared about me, who cared that I was moving. The other people, at least, four of them at least signed the shirt, because I knew they couldn't come because they had other stuff. But other people, it felt like they just made excuses. Maybe that wasn't the case, but I felt terrible moving. So, I moved. And leading up to me moving, I remember making videos with him of saying goodbye. And we moved, like, they went up on his channel, but we moved after that, me and my family, and I remember when we got there, I made one last video saying goodbye, saying, one last time, I am sorry that I had to move, to leave, and then I made that video, and I looked on his channel to see one last video that said, it was him saying goodbye. And it was the most heartwarming video I had ever seen. Of him telling the story of what he remembers when I moved there. Of all the funny, hilarious things that we did, and I wish I could find that video, but I can't. It's gone. So, he made that video, and I was so mad at how the church treated my family. I didn't talk to him until this year, till last month. I reached out to him, and it was a Snapchat thing. You know, I friended him on Facebook, and I put my Snapchat account on Facebook, and he friended me on there the day before he died. And he sent me this photo of somebody with him in a car. And I know it's not the photo of who was with him in the car before he died in that car wreck, but I never said goodbye. I never responded. I don't know who was in the car with him. I could barely tell. But he sent me something. And I sat there and ignored it. And I feel like a terrible person now. So, this is me saying goodbye. I will always remember everything you did. Everything you did for me. Everything you did to make my life special. You will always be a part of my life. You will always be somebody that influenced who I am. I want to say thank you. And I wish right now I could give you a hug. But right now, I gotta say goodbye. For now. Because I know with the person you were, I will see you again someday. Because I remember the last thing you said to me in that video was that you decided before I moved there, you wanted to be the guy that drank and I remember in that video you were telling me all the stuff you used to want to be, and now after that you decided you wanted to be a better person, and I believe you were. I believe you are the best person a man could be. So I'm going to see you again someday. And I know with what happened, God may have not caused this, but He's going to use it for something good. He's going to use this thing in my life for something. So I'm saying goodbye to your channel, to your videos, and I'm saying goodbye to you. So yeah. Goodbye. Okay.